Everyone, it's Hannah, and today I am so pumped because I'm going to be sharing with you guys my first tag that I ever created, and I created this with the two amazing girls from The Key to Beauty 3, and their video will be listed down below of them doing this tag, and so you can go subscribe to their channel because they're awesome, they're so sweet, and I had so much fun talking to them and coming up with the questions for this tag and the name. That took a while, but we finally got it. So this is the Beauty Guru in the Making tag, and basically it's just questions about beauty gurus and what they do before their videos and little questions about their videos and stuff like that. So if you're a beauty guru, then you should totally do this tag and tag people, because we want to get this spread out as far as we can, and I'll be tagging some specific people down below, so you better do this tag. No, I'm just kidding, you don't have to do it, but just spread it and do this tag if you're a beauty guru, so that we can know just sort of what goes on with you when you're filming, or what it has video things about how you film, what videos you like filming. It's actually cool because you get to see sort of what goes on behind the scenes of a video. And I know a lot of people don't make beauty videos, they just watch them, and it's sort of cool, I don't know, to sort of see how much work goes into making a video. Different for everyone. But yeah, I did questions and they did questions, so they're all mixed in here. So let's go ahead and get started with number one, which is, what camera do you use? I currently use the Canon EOS Rebel T3i. I got it for Christmas 2 years ago, and I love it. It's amazing. It's very durable. I've used it. It has like baking stuff. I think it has like baking powder in one of the consoles, sand from when I took it to the beach, makeup on it from when I'm like doing tutorials. It's very durable, and a lot of people ask me this through emails and comments. It does not have autofocus. Every EOS Rebel after it, like the T4i, the T5i, do have autofocus, but this one is a manual focus, so like that. Okay, question number two, do you do any special makeup or hair before filming, you know, to sort of look presentable, I guess? I mean, I don't do specific. Obviously, my makeup and hair is different in every video, but I do have a few go-to products, like a foundation that I'll just always put on. Well, I'm now starting to always put on for a video just to even out my skin tone. And my hair, today's hair was terrible. It was in a bun all day, and it was all dirty, and it was disgusting. So I opted for a braid, but you guys don't know that, right? Hopefully you don't. Hopefully you're not looking that closely. But if I have a good hair day, I'll wear it down. So it's just sort of however it's going with that day. Number three, do you clean your room or just the area people see? And I think everyone would say just the area people see, unless you're a clean freak and organize everything, which is awesome. Don't stop. But right now, like, my bed's right there and my wall and wall's right there, so I'm closed in. And to seriously move around my room, I have to move my whole lighting system. And there's clothes, clean clothes. It's actually sort of giving me a small heart attack just thinking about what I have to do to clean it. But that's okay. I'll clean it after. Moving on. So this area may look nice always, but you don't want to turn around. Number four, are you wearing real pants or yoga, PJs, etc.? I'm on a spinny chair, but woo, pajamas. I love wearing comfortable pants. Like, even on school days in the mornings, I will keep my pajama pants on till the last minute that I can before I put my jeans on. I love being comfortable. And as soon as I get home, pants are off and PJs are on. Number five, natural light or studio lighting system? Currently, I'm using the studio lighting system. I got it off of Amazon at a really good price. They came with two. I will leave a link below to the Amazon in case you want to get them. However, I don't know if I prefer, which one I prefer better. I feel like natural lighting is definitely obviously more natural. So using the sun, I really tried to do that. But during the winter, it gets dark really late, and it's now 6:15, so it's already dark. And I needed to film this video tonight because I'm putting it up tomorrow. And so I have to go with the studio lighting because I can film and it's not all dark and you can see me. So I don't know which one I prefer. Probably studio lighting if I could just pick one, because then you can always film. But with natural lighting, you can only do it in the day. We're on number six. Do you feel / did you feel awkward talking to a camera? And this question, I'm going to try to answer briefly, but basically no, because if you don't, I don't think I ever was, because when I started YouTube, if you don't know, I started with making doll videos, so those I did stop motion, so it's just pictures. I didn't show my face until about a year after I started doing YouTube, And actually before then, like ever since I think I was like 10 or 11, so like 3 or 4 years ago, I used to make beauty videos on my laptop. It was terrible quality, it lagged, so it would like, you would re-hear my voice like echoing. And I barely knew anything about makeup, but I loved watching beauty videos and I wanted to make my own, but I couldn't like do YouTube, so I just recorded them on my little laptop when I was younger. And let me know if you guys want to see like one or two of those videos, maybe sometime. I don't know, they're really funny, I think, to look back and see what I was talking about. I was like doing tutorials. Anyway. And since those, I knew like those videos on my laptop weren't going anywhere, I was just sort of talking to like myself in the mirror basically. And that's how I feel now. I feel like I'm just talking to, I mean, I guess I feel like I'm talking to you guys some too, but it sort of just feels like I'm talking to myself. Because I like used to talk to, I always talk to myself in the mirror like when I'm getting ready using the products and stuff. So it just feels like I'm doing that now sort of. But so I don't think I ever felt awkward. Maybe I am awkward. Maybe I just don't know. Maybe you think I'm awkward to watch. I don't know. But I've been talking to a camera for quite a while now. Number 7, do you like filming outside or inside? And I prefer doing sitting down talking videos like this inside, just because there's not as much noises. I mean, my brother's laughing downstairs with his friend. I don't know if you can hear that, but there isn't as many noises as outside. But if I'm doing like a lookbook or fashion or tutorial or something where it's like inspired by outdoors, then I'll definitely film outside. I think it's fun to film outside too. Do you edit your bloopers out or leave them in? And it just depends on the video. I don't know what I'll be doing on this video, but if the video gets really long, like over 9 or 8 minutes, then I probably won't leave the bloopers in. I'll just delete them. But if it's like a 6-minute video, I may just put the few bloopers that I have. I never mess up. No, the bloopers that I have, I'll put at the end. It just depends if I want the video to be longer, because sometimes it's just way over time, like this one. I need to pick it up. Okay. Fine. Do you like filming at night or during the day? Right now it's winter, so as I said, it gets dark really early, so I usually am filming at night, especially since I have school, then dance, so I get home when it gets dark. So night right now, but in the summer, I definitely like filming during the day. 10, how long does it take you to get ready for a video? Okay, I just got home at 6 o'clock. I practiced these questions, redid my makeup, hair, set up my lighting system, and it is now, well, I started the tag at like 6:15. So basically it took me about 10 minutes to get set up for this video, moved my tripod, checked camera settings, put up lights, turned them on, did some makeup and hair, and this is a shirt I wore to dance, and I'm here. So 10 to 15 minutes usually, 15 minutes tops I would say. I usually, oh, and I lit a candle, which you can't even see, but it's there. Number 11, how long does it take you to edit your videos? I don't know. It depends, again. It depends, depends. If I'm editing just a video like this using iMovie, I've sort of mastered iMovie, I feel, because I can just like clip, 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 edit out, delete, add a subtitle, add an effect, whatever. So I can usually, I'll probably edit this video in 15 to 20 minutes. However, I got a new editing software, in case you're wondering. It's Adobe Premiere Elements 12, and I edited my like winter break sort of lookbook, or what I wore over winter break, or something titled like that. That took me like two to three hours, just because it was my first time using the editing software. The music wasn't working. It would not upload to YouTube, guys. I don't know what was wrong. I had to upload it at least 5 times. And it was crazy. So that took me a while to edit. But usually if I'm just doing a quick talking video like this, I can edit it 30 minutes tops. Usually. 12. We're almost done. 12. What's your favorite video to film? I really like these videos where I sit down and talk. I mean, don't get me wrong, I love filming tutorials and I love editing tutorials and lookbooks. But I really just like talking to the camera. So like favorites videos or reviews or empties videos, which I need to do an empties video, is like getting really full. But I really like the sitting down and talking, which they can be sort of longer, I'm sorry, but I like to talk, so yeah. What's the longest video it takes you to film, which is number 13 and the last question. Probably my favorites and my sitting down talking videos, like we're almost at 11 minutes and I've just been talking for straight 11 minutes. But so yeah, probably like a favorites video or empties, something where I'm reviewing a product or talking about a product, because I go on and on and ramble and go on rabbit trails. So that is this tag. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Make sure if you are a beauty guru and you make videos, then do this tag, because I want to know about it. And make sure you tell me in a comment that you did it. There we go. Just tell me in a comment that you did the video and I will go to your channel and check it out and like it and favorite it and whatever. Go make sure you check out the Key to Beauty 3, who also helped me make this tag, and subscribe to them. And yeah, check out who I tagged below specifically. And I guess that's all. So I will see y'all in my next video. Bye.